GOG.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. GOG.ninja. Code FTL.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting. And they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays. Exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit. Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We'll get back to the Twitter story in just a second, but first I want to tell you about ExpressCoin.com. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Litecoin, or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They are a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrencies with money order or check. Just start off at ExpressCoin.com. Whether it's in the U.S. or Canada, ExpressCoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app at ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency with no fee. That's no fee at all on up to $40 worth of crypto with code FTL. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL.
So, again, to repeat, just to recap a little bit, Politwhoops, this site that holds on to politicians' accidental or stupid tweets, stopped surfacing tweets a couple weeks ago. And posted a blog, again, a couple weeks ago, calling on Twitter to restore its API access. However, Twitter decided to cut it off permanently yesterday, on June 3rd, calling it a privacy issue. They said, we strongly support... Sorry, I'm just actually reacting to the cut it off. They just...
And how is it...
They didn't completely remove their access to Twitter. They just cut off just the tip, just the API part. They didn't allow them
So what you're saying is Twitter circumcised Pollet Whoop's access.
Yes. So, and they say in their quote, we strongly support Sunlight's mission of increasing transparency in politics, but preserving deleted tweets.
But there's always like, but, yeah.
All right. So there was a radio host that I used to listen to probably 10 to 15 years ago.
Let me finish this quote here because I was in the middle of a quote here. So okay. We strongly support Sunlight's mission of increasing transparency in politics, but preserving deleted tweets violates our developer agreement.
So this talk show host that I used to listen to, he had a saying that one of the rules of grammar is anything before the word but, just remove.
Yeah.
So no matter, like, Derrick J., I really like you. You're one of the nicest guys I know, but that shirt is absolutely horrible. So just ignore everything that was said before the word but.
So if the, we were to do that, basically what Twitter said was preserving deleted tweets violates our developer agreement.
But it doesn't. I mean, yeah, I guess I don't know exactly how it's written, but if you're copying the tweet, you're making a new one. What you have is not a deleted tweet, it is a live tweet.
It's preserving the deleted tweet though in a way.
You're keeping record
okay.
of
yeah. You can't make a copy of something?
I don't know.
You cannot make a copy of this. I mean, how ridiculous is that? Why not?
Yeah, it is ridiculous. It shouldn't even be in their policy, but I don't know what their reasoning is for it. An individual claiming to be a Twitter employee told Gawker that...
Well, what about screenshots? Can't you take screenshots? What about news articles?
As a developer, this is not a thing for individuals. This is for developers. So this is a different situation. It says, an individual claiming to be a Twitter employee told Gawker that until recently, the social network was considering a quiet reversal of the decision. However, it reportedly wound up digging in so as not to create a snowball effect of developers wanting exceptions.
No, but there should be exceptions for politicians that if politicians tweet something, their tweets can be preserved. There's no deleting your tweets if you're some congressman or president.
Right. And there is, you know, the fair point here is that there is nothing for them to use some sort of automated, you know, robot or whatever, or something to scrape the website and actually pull the tweets still anyway.
Yeah.
From all the feeds. I mean, you can still view Twitter feeds through, you know, without the API.
Well, any roadblock with technology where they're like, you're not allowed to do this. All they're saying is you have to find a new way to do this because there's going to be a way around it.
Generally, yeah.
Right. So somebody will create something that takes screenshots automatically instead of retweeting automatically.
We can only hope. And for a site like Pollet Whoops, I certainly hope so. And I like to, you know, just the idea of getting this out there because I think it's a great idea in a website.
Now, I'm curious if any of these deleted tweets are still available somewhere online.
I'm assuming most of Pollet Whoops, I would assume that they're still there, I think. Maybe, maybe not.
I don't know. I'm on the site and it does not seem to be anything that actually functions at all. Maybe I'm... You know, on some page that doesn't seem... Oh, okay. So the front page of Pollet Whoops actually has some preserved tweets here. One of them is from Representative Walter Jones. Says, thank you to all who have served and currently served. Hashtag Armed Forces Day. I don't see what is, weird about that. Like, why would that be deleted? Unless he didn't actually post it on Armed Forces Day.
Maybe.
There's, you know, other politicians here and nothing that really seems to be anything that I would consider to be like a big whoops tweet of, oh, I can't believe I tweeted that.
Well, who knows? Maybe some of the data was lost. I don't know, you know.
True. I don't know. This just seems to be that they're retweeting everything from a bunch of different politicians. And maybe that's what they were doing, was just retweeting everything from anybody that was a member of Congress.
Maybe.
And somehow preserving that. And it
are you looking at tweets on openstate.eu or on Politwhoops?
Politwhoops.sunlightfoundation.com.
Okay.
And appears to be 777 pages of tweets. And whenever you go to a page, something pops up that says, on June 3rd, the Sunlight Foundation received word from Twitter that it was pulling the plug on Politwhoops, reversing an agreement made in 2012 that allowed us to run the project using its API. And then they have a eulogy for Politwhoops. So let me pull up this eulogy. It says, in 2012, Twitter made the decision to allow Sunlight to curate the deleted tweets from lawmakers and those seeking elected office. Last night, that all changed. When we launched Politwhoops 3 years ago, our goal was to create accountability and a public record for the messages elected officials and candidates for president, vice president, Congress, and governor published on social media, particularly those public statements they delete.
Which politician do you think told Twitter, hey, cut these guys out?
Probably Rick Santorum, because he seems to have a lot of tweets that when you see them and read it, you're like, really? Somebody didn't like proofread that?
Yeah, he doesn't have a Twitter guy.
So this site, what it is it's automated. So it's just automatically capturing. It's got a, you know, a list of politicians that it's put in there. It's capturing, or it was capturing, all of their tweets, right, from all of these politicians.
Yeah.
And then what it was doing is it was, if they delete, excuse me, if it deleted a tweet, it was posting it to their website. There was no filter for, is this tweet juicy or not? It was just, if it's deleted, they grab it and post it to their website.
Huh. Okay.
So, I mean, it would be
so
up to the users.
So maybe they would like make a mistake, or it's a small error or
sure.
something.
So like, you know, most of these are probably, you know, not anything juicy or whatnot, but it would be, this is how you would catch the ones that are.
Yeah. You know? What a great little tool.
Right. You know, and there's no way, you know, it's like, how would they filter out, you know, what's something that's, you know, oh my God, this is crazy. We caught a deleted tweet that's like, this is juicy. I can't believe they made such a huge flub.
You would have to have somebody going through
right.
and looking at everything. And
instead what they're doing is crowdsourcing that by making it publicly available information, and then somebody can then tag it and like
right.
it.
And in some ways I see this kind of like the raw channel of YouTube stuff, to where here's 15 hours of Robinhooding
right.
from today, and 90% of it is just feet walking and music playing.
And yet that channel is one of the most subscribed channels in New Hampshire.
Wow. It is, but very few of the videos actually have views.
Well, combined, though.
Do politicians have Twitter guys? Is there someone who's in charge of that now? They have
some
social media people,
do.
Right?
Most of the...
They've got to have some kind of protection, because these guys are so out of touch. There's got to be some way they have to pretend to be like with it, with
so
the people, and interactive.
Most of the ones that are, you know, fairly well off and have large campaign funds, they will hire a social media guy. And the social media guy runs the Facebook. And I'm using the gender neutral guy. So like they've got it. They've got a person. Like, have your people call my people. Like, they've got people.
All right.
But it's generally, like, a person, and that person runs their social networking stuff for them. Hour number three is next after the news. Your calls, welcome, 855-450-FREE.
They say life is about choices. So let me introduce you to one of the best choices you can make in life, Granger Choice. The Granger Choice product line has just about everything we need to keep this place running, from batteries to V-belts, safety to sump pumps. And with Granger Choice, we can trust that every product is dependable and cost-effective. When it comes to making life choices, here's a great one. Granger Choice. Get it? Got it? Good. Call, click Granger.com/choice, or stop by. Granger. for the ones who get it done.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, June 11th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.88 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,179 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $233. Antiwar.com reports, with just a few days left until the UN-brokered peace talks in Geneva, fighting is once again escalating in Yemen, particularly around the southern city of Aden, where forces loyal to the former government fought with members of the Shiite Houthi movement in heavy clashes that left at least 43 people dead. Saudi forces picked up their airstrikes against the Shiites in several other provinces across central Yemen as well, fueling more civilian displacement across the nation and what aid groups are warning is a soaring humanitarian crisis. Despite the new fighting, the indications are still that both sides will be taking part in the Geneva talks, though the Saudi government is not expected to play much of a role, having repeatedly ruled out any peace talks and demanded unconditional surrender from the Houthis. That the talks are happening at all, however, reflects the increasing war exhaustion on both sides and the increasing realization that neither side is going to be able to secure an outright military victory in anything resembling a timely fashion, and instead are looking for some sort of settlement. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports a representative from the National Park Service on Wednesday said the agency does not object to an Alaska senator's bid to rename Mount McKinley to Mount Denali. Victor Knox, the Associate Director of Planning, Facilities, and Land at the Park Service, spoke before the Senate Energy and Natural Resources Subcommittee on National Park hearings. The subcommittee was considering a bill authored by Senator Lisa Murkowski from Alaska that would rename North America's highest mountain. Knox said the National Park Service appreciates the long history and public interest for both the name Mount McKinley and traditional Athabascan name Denali. The department respects the choice made by the legislation and does not object. Murkowski said she's pushing the legislation to reinstate Mount McKinley's native name, Mount Denali, which means high one. The mountain was renamed after the 25th President of the United States, William McKinley, in 1971, though the state of Alaska officially changed the name back to Denali in 1975. Despite that change, the U.S. Board of Geographic Names continues to list the peak as Mount McKinley. Murkowski's bill faces opposition from U.S. Representative Bob Gibbs from Ohio, who hails from the same state as McKinley. In January, he introduced a bill to affirm the name as Mount McKinley.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the Los Angeles City Council on Wednesday gave final approval to an ordinance raising the minimum wage in America's second largest city to $15 an hour by 2020 from the current rate of $9 per hour. The measure, which still must be signed into law by Mayor Eric Garcetti, would require businesses with more than 25 employees to gradually increase wages to meet a $15 per hour pay level by 2020, while smaller businesses would have an extra year to comply with each step. Garcetti, a Democrat, has said that he would sign the wage hike into law, seen as a victory for labor and community groups that have successfully pushed for similar pay hikes in other major U.S. cities, including Seattle and San Francisco. Rusty Hicks of the Los Angeles County Federation of Labor said in a written statement issued after the vote, "Today is a great day for Los Angeles and the people who work hard to make our city a vibrant place to live and work." Opponents of minimum wage hikes say they place an undue burden on businesses and will force employers to lay off workers or move. The federal minimum wage has remained at $7.25 an hour since 2009. Supporters of raising pay for the lowest paid workers have expressed little hope for an increase from the Republican-controlled U.S. Congress. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
People love photography, but when we thought about photography, we realized one thing. Humans are limited to looking at photos with our eyes. That's a problem, right? So we made an app, Pixong, the first program that turns your photos into music if you want to do that for some reason. It puts the power in your hands. You get to decide why you need this. I can't tell you why you need this. It's not my job. Who is this app for? Maybe it's for students, or artists, or blind people. But can it turn your music into photos? No, it can't. Do you get to keep the original photo? No, it gets deleted. Always back up your photos before using Pixong.
This is the Onion News Network.
Kicking off hour number three, this is Free Talk Live. Your calls welcome, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Ian and Mark are in New York City. They'll be back on Saturday tonight. It's Darryl.
Derrick J.
And Johnson.
And we were talking about social media in the last hour. And that reminded me of a story that I saw but have not read. Like, I skimmed through it during the news. The title is, "Before You Unfriend Your Facebook Pal, There's Something You Should Know." And I had saved it. Like, Facebook has this save feature to where you can click, like, you know, save.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh,
okay. So instead of having to share it.
So in the top right of a post?
Yeah.
Okay.
From the little drop-down menu. So instead of like sharing it and put to read later, you right. can actually save, and then there's a save folder on your Facebook.
I only know one person in my friends list who does that to read later thing all the time, and she also likes to post lots of posts about cats. She knows who she is.
Yes, I know who she is too. She is so cute. But anyway, the story here from Mad World News, a site that I have not heard of before. Now, they write, "Remember the days when you could be friends with someone and not necessarily know their every opinion about the hot topic issues? Thanks to social media, those days are no more. If you are Facebook friends, you often know what the other thinks about the big stories making the rounds."
Why are they saying this like it's a bad thing? Like, you don't really want to know your friend's opinions, do you? I mean, I think this is closer connection. This is good.
This is sort of like what Facebook wants, though. They want to choose what you see. They want to control your worldview.
When those highly debatable issues come into the spotlight and opinions are voiced, friendships can collide. Caitlyn Jenner was the hot topic this week, they report. Friends on the left and friends on the right are throwing in their two cents on the social media accounts. Obviously, those on the right tend to hold the less popular, less politically correct opinion. So, of course, that means the B word is coming out. That's right. Bigotry.
Mm.
After posting an article discussing Dr. Paul R. Merkhew's controversial assertion that transgenderism is a medical disorder and sex reassignment is biologically impossible, I lost some friends, writes the author.
Is that the article?
Says, you can imagine.
I think that Derrick and I might have talked about this article. Is that the article that we talked about on Flaming Freedom last Thursday?
I can't be certain, but we did talk about a very similar topic. Perhaps transgender people have a mental illness, and it's not really possible to ever change your gender completely, at least not today.
I heard somebody making the argument one day that they were saying something very similar of, well, you can get the plumbing changed, but you're not removing the X chromosome or the Y chromosome, so you're still whatever. And as I don't like, you can change your appearance, and like, Johnson, if you for some reason started taking hormones, then like, you could very much look like a woman. And if I didn't know that you were Johnson beforehand, then I'd be like, wow, Joanna, you look pretty good.
Actually, being in my mid-30s, I think it's a little bit late for hormones to have much of an effect on me.
Well, Caitlyn Jenner is almost 70.
And Caitlyn Jenner has gone through multiple surgeries.
Right.
Over and over again.
Taking hormones.
Well, yeah.
So it's hormones.
But you just
and
said
surgery.
The hormones. You didn't mention the surgeries.
I said, and you get the cosmetics changed.
Yeah, well, okay.
So, like, you get your plumbing changed, and you get...
I'm not even sure why this is a topic. I mean, part of me is conspiratorial and thinks, what are they trying to prevent people from talking about? Like, what is the story
Saudi Arabia bombing Yemen, the U.S. military killing hundreds of civilians in Yemen, in Syria.
Did that happen?
That's been happening. Saudi Arabia has been...
The same week as Caitlyn Jenner?
Saudi Arabia has been bombing Yemen for about 2.5 months. I've not seen it once on mainstream media.
See, my thought is that it's not this... Like, you know, and every time I hear these conspiracies and whatnot, I don't feel like it's actually a conspiracy. I feel like Americans just don't care. Like, they care more... They don't care about the bombings in Syria and Yemen. Like, the average American's like, I don't care about that. Oh, what's going on with Bruce Jenner? He's an Olympian.
Yeah, so
she's an Olympian.
There was one time I posted something on Facebook about, you know, want to watch the football game. And I got probably like 15, 20 comments about, you should pay attention to the other stuff. And I then just like listed a whole bunch of new stuff. It was like, yeah, I already know all about all of this. I just want to relax for the next 3 hours.
I have this problem with activists, though, that think that it's one or the other. Like, you can only pay attention to what's going on in the world or celebrities. You can't pay attention to both, and that's just not true.
Right, because how many activists do you know that basically their activism is sitting in a room listening to music, smoking pot?
Right.
That's not... What are you talking about? That's not activism at all.
I know people that do that and call it activism.
Okay, well...
And then they give me a hard time because I watch pro football or pro wrestling and college football.
No one's giving you a hard time here.
But right. As far as I'm concerned, if you are a Free State Project participant and you want to move to New Hampshire and sit in your room and listen to Grateful Dead and smoke pot, and you only come out every few years to
vote. Are there a lot of people like that?
I don't think that there are, but if there are people that want to do that and they only come out of their rooms or whatever every few years to vote.
That's cool.
Cool. Awesome. Make the move. Yeah. Sign up today. Because I don't care. If there are activists that just want to come here and have fun and like every so often they vote and they believe in freedom, good on you. Get up here.
Yeah, right. I think that, yeah, Big Ten. We need to have all kinds of people.
My whole point is just because I entertain myself differently from you, don't judge me about the way I entertain myself.
I'm not.
I didn't say either one of you were.
All right, Darryl, I won't judge you about the way you entertain yourself.
I'm not sure why you're laughing maniacally. Let's get back to the article here. Considering that Dr. McHugh is the former psychiatrist in chief at renowned Johns Hopkins Hospital and current distinguished service professor of psychiatry there, I thought his informed opinion was information worth sharing. Apparently, this was a friendship faux pas, and I lost a couple of friends. Because the article contained factual information from a professional and was in no way an assertion of my opinion, I wasn't really all that bothered. But then there comes the threats and that B word, bigotry, that doesn't mean what they think it means. And it's time to clear it up right now.
What's it mean?
Happily scrolling my feed as I sip my coffee this morning, I see yet another status threatening the dreaded unfriend. I stop and read to see what button is being pushed for this particular Facebook user, and as no surprise, it was Caitlyn Jenner. I'll paraphrase here, but the gist is that if you post anything negative about transgender or disagree with Caitlyn being called a hero, you will be deleted. Okay, no big deal. It's the user's prerogative, but then I see it. Yep, the B word. I'm deleting anyone who spews ignorant bigotry. And that's when I can barely stand the irony. And we'll finish this article in just a moment, but Chris, calling in from Cooper City, Florida, wants to talk about a speeding ticket. Chris, hopefully you did not just get a speeding ticket while you were on hold for Free Talk Live.
No, not right now. Hey, Mark. Hey, Ian. Huge fan.
Mark and Ian are on not really vacation. They're down in New York City for the Talkers Convention.
You've got the B team tonight.
In studio tonight, it's Darryl, Derrick, Jay, and Johnson.
Hey, we ain't no B team.
That's still fine. So I was going to talk about a couple of things.
Well, you're going to have to talk about those things when we come back from break.
Yeah. All right. So sorry. Just hold on, Chris. We will get to you. And, of course, your calls are welcome as well. 855-450-FREE. And after Chris tells us about his speeding ticket, we'll continue talking about, is it bigotry to unfriend someone on Facebook?
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big-name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. Simply Safe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, Simply safe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it. And that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. Simply Safe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. Simply Safe. Go to simplysafedefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's simplysafedefense.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. In studio tonight, it's Darryl,
Derrick J.
And Johnson.
And Chris, we'll get back to you in just a second to talk about speeding tickets. But you do need to protect yourself, not just from the cops, but also from your internet service provider and the feds. Because your internet service provider is likely saving your surfing history. Criminals are possibly sniffing your Wi-Fi packets. Governments and corporations are limiting what you can see on the internet, not to mention the NSA sweeping up metadata. ProXPN can solve all of that. Simply download an app for Windows, Mac, iOS, or Android, even Linux, but the setup is just a little different. Then just connect to the internet and you're protected from all of that. No more prying, no more spying. One account works for all of your devices. No need to have a separate account for each device. Just go to proxpn.com/FTL and you will get 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with our code FTL50. That's almost $5 a month. That's for the lifetime of the account, no matter which premium account you go with. With the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth with servers all around the world to access, the ability to privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and this is important, ProXPN does not keep your records of your online habits. You get all of that with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. Use coupon code FTL50. Get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. And Chris, calling in from Cooper City, Florida, want to talk about a speeding ticket. What's on your mind?
Yeah, so there's a couple of things on my mind. One is related to the speeding ticket, and the other one is immigration situation in this country. I'm an immigrant.
I came over from India about 10 years ago. Currently, I have my permanent residency card, what you call the green card, for the past couple of years. I thought this country was based on taxation with representation, which I don't get any representation because I don't qualify to vote or anything. Mm-hmm. And it's not like I'm excited to go and vote for the scumbags that are there out there.
Well, yeah. Chris, anyway. let me tell you, I do vote, but I'm not represented by the people that claim to represent me, because they generally do the complete opposite of what I would prefer that they do. So even though I supposedly am being represented, yeah, taxation with representation is no better than without. It's still some government somewhere stealing money from you.
You're probably right. I pay a bunch of taxes every year for the past 10 years. There's probably a lot of services that I really don't need, or something that I don't want them to do, which they're doing. Coming to my speeding ticket issue, this has been a while. I chose to go, you know, go to trial. I was just wondering what you guys' thoughts are on that. And number two, I rescheduled my date, and I'm hoping that the judge would reschedule my trial date because I have work on that day. So I don't know how the process works, because the police officers have already been subpoenaed. And at least down here in South Florida, or in Florida, even the cop who's handing the ticket over usually says, just go ahead and pay the attorneys and they'll take care of it for you. They actually suggest things like that.
Right. Of course they suggest that you pay it, because that's really the point of a speeding ticket, is to increase their revenue. Now, as far as getting the hearing postponed, I am guessing it would be the same process down in Florida as it is in New Hampshire, where you file a motion with the court asking for a continuance, and you just say, like, I cannot make the hearing on this day, please set a later date. In New Hampshire, everybody gets one. So they'll give the plaintiff and the defendant both one continuance, basically no questions asked. If you want additional, then, you know, they might have some kind of hearing of, well, hey, wait a second, we've already given you one, why do you need another? Derrick, do you have any suggestions?
Have you been to an arraignment yet? Or do you even know if there is one before your official trial?
No, I've been to a pre-trial. I don't know if that's called arraignment. There was a pre-trial summons that I had to go to the court for.
And what happened there? Did the judge ask you if you're going to plead guilty or not guilty?
Yep.
Yeah, that's what is commonly referred to as an arraignment. And you decided to plead not guilty, correct?
Yep.
And how far out is the trial date? Have you heard yet?
The trial date is on the 16th of this month. And I filed a motion couple of days ago.
Okay. What motion did you file?
To postpone the date to some other date.
Yeah. I would assume that there's some window of time before the trial that you have to file that, but they'll probably excuse it.
Yeah, I don't know. Here right. In New Hampshire, all motions are supposed to be filed at least 10 days before the trial.
Yeah.
So if your hearing's on the 16th, and you filed this just a couple of days ago, then I doubt that they will wind up granting that. They might want you to show up that day. And then I've seen people where they filed the motion for continuance, they never got a response, so they had to show up on the day. And the judge said, well, you're here, we're going on with trial. Doesn't matter if you're not prepared. Right. You showed up, therefore you're ready.
Well, wait a minute. If he's not there on trial day and the judge sees in his docket...
Then they put out a bench warrant.
No, wait a minute. The judge sees in his docket that he has filed a motion for continuance.
Never ruled on it.
Yeah, but couldn't he just say, I'm going to rule on this now, give the guy his continuance?
He could, or he could say, I've not ruled on this, he's not here, bench warrant.
Okay, so...
It's judge's discretion. And you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't.
Wow.
So if you show up and you're not prepared, then, well, you're here, we're going ahead anyway. Well, so if you don't show up, bench warrant, and then they throw you in jail for contempt.
Chris, what kind of strategy do you have going into court?
Yeah, I have no strategy. I was going to ask you guys if you guys could suggest something.
If they did, well, let me ask this question. Did they use one of these radar guns to say that you were speeding? Okay, so what I would do is ask for the calibration records of the device, and if they cannot provide the calibration records, then I would request a dismissal for lack of them being able to prove that the device they used was accurate. And if they do wind up providing that, then, you know, I really don't have any other suggestions for you.
Well, I tried something kind of different this week in court where I challenged jurisdiction, not recommending that strategy to you one way or another, but
at all.
It may not work.
I tried that in South Carolina one time and was threatened with contempt no less than 5 times.
Basically, the argument is,
and told that if I mentioned the Constitution, I would go to jail.
This basically, court is based on naval admiralty, and I am not a vessel at sea.
That's not it.
Chris, hold on. We'll bring you back in just a moment. We can discuss some court advice, but of course, we are not attorneys. And we are not necessarily giving legal advice. We're just speaking from personal experience. This is Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenevention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenevention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenevention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking with Chris from Florida, and Chris has a speeding ticket coming up, and we're trying to give some advice based on our experiences in court. And Derrick, you were saying that you tried
show up.
Something.
That's the best thing you can do. Half the time, the cop won't show up, and you just win by default. So show up. That's the best thing you can probably do. It's the best advice I can give you. All the things I've tried haven't really worked.
Right. So what was the jurisdiction thing that you started to tell us about?
Well, basically, what I was getting at is...
Before you were so rudely interrupted.
How can I be held in this courtroom unless the judge is assuming jurisdiction over me? And jurisdiction is one of the elements of the crime. So am I presumed innocent? The judge will say yes. But to be innocent, I have to be innocent of all of the elements of the crime, of which jurisdiction is one. So if the judge has me in his courtroom, assuming jurisdiction, which is one of the elements of the crime.
Where are you getting the information that you have to be innocent of the jurisdiction before you can
From the judge himself, I asked him. I asked him when I went into the courtroom. I said, I intend to plead guilty, Your Honor. But before I do, I just have a couple of questions.
And
so this gets him a little bit excited, like, okay, we can get this done and over with pretty quick because we've got the plea of guilty and Derek's not going to go to court and hooray, we're going to stop wasting everybody's time. But no, I'm there to do exactly that. And so I'm asking, well, actually, I want to know the answer to this question. I know they don't have it. What evidence do they have that the laws of the state of New Hampshire apply to me?
You've got a driver's license, and you signed on the line, therefore, we own you.
If that's what they say, then I will object, because that was signed under duress.
Doesn't matter. You signed it, and you did not put under duress next to your signature.
Contracts signed under duress are not valid contracts.
Doesn't matter. We own you.
That's the appeal to the stick. And this is not helpful for Chris. I mean, this was just... my, you know, attempt at, exposing that the court really has no jurisdiction, has no legitimate authority.
Right, but my question, Derek, would be why are you pleading guilty when you could plead and have the same results, nolo condendere? You know that one?
I think because the plea of guilty is really just a carrot on a stick for the judge.
I guess, yeah.
It's
so
like,
no contest, really. But
No, because he wants the plea of guilty. That's good for the prosecutor, right?
Okay.
Like they want me to sign this piece of paper that's right on his desk and ready to go. Like, plea of guilty, let's get this over with.
Right.
Just answer the question. If you have evidence that the laws of New Hampshire apply to me, put them forward.
Right.
And let's get this over with.
Right. But my question about the jurisdiction thing, to where you're saying that they must prove that you're innocent of all aspects of the charge before they can drop
the
charge.
They must assume me innocent. The judge says he assumes me innocent. I ask him, you know, judge, am I presumed innocent of all of the elements of the crime? He says, yes. Jurisdiction is one of the elements of the crime. So how can he hold me in his courtroom? That's just one of the elements of all crimes, jurisdiction. That in order to charge Darryl, in order to say, Darryl, I'm pulling you over, you violated a order of this
the law
government,
has to be of a
then the law has to apply to you. So
you
jurisdiction is one of the elements of a crime.
Yeah. You have to have violated crime. A law of a particular area.
Right. I understand that, but like, you know, they're not going to find me not guilty of having been within the geographic area of New Hampshire.
No,
like that's not a charge of you are in New Hampshire, therefore give us $5 because you parked at an expired meter.
No. They're saying because I'm in New Hampshire, their laws apply to me, and that's why they have the authority to pull me into the courtroom in the first place. That's why I'm objecting right from the get-go. Right at arraignment, before trial even begins, I'm saying, listen, how can you hold me here? Unless you're assuming me guilty of one of the aspects of this crime already, jurisdiction.
Chris, do you have any more thoughts on, has any of this actually helped you prepare for your trial? I guess it helps Chris if I click the on-air button. Chris, has this actually helped you in any way?
Probably did help me. The other thing is that they down here, they usually have time slots. And I work close to the courthouse, so I know what happens over there. There's like a bunch of police cars of different, you know, cities or counties all lined up during certain times of the month. And that's how they slot them so that everyone's subpoenaed out at the same time and all the people show up at the same time. So I'm pretty sure the officer is going to show up. So the second point is that when he pulled me over, he said, oh, you were doing 64 in a speed zone of 40 or 45. But then when he actually wrote me the ticket, he wrote down 63 miles per hour, not 64.
That's not a big deal.
I do not have video evidence of that, but that's something I
know. It's not a big deal.
It's not a big deal, but it still shows an inaccuracy of the police officer, and maybe the thing said 44, and he read it as 64.
Couldn't you file a request for the dash cam? Is there audio on a dash cam?
There was no dash cam evidence because he was literally, this is a speed trap. They just literally stand on one of the street corners, and they just come right, walk right in the middle of the street, they'll pull you over. They don't even have a car. They just pull you over by walking in the middle of the street.
Wow. So one thing you can do, Chris, that might be successful is getting the witness disqualified as incompetent. If you get him on the stand during cross-examination, you can ask him some questions that might get him to contradict himself. And if so, he could be ruled incompetent to testify. So one example is, you know, you wrote me this ticket. Yes. You assume me guilty of this crime. Yes. Of all of the elements of the crime. Yes. What are the elements of a crime? He doesn't know, he's found incompetent to testify.
And also, if he's relying on notes to testify against you, you can object to that and say the witness should testify based on his recollection of memory, not from things that he has written down. And if he continues, then motion the court to dismiss the witness as being incompetent because he is not testifying from memory. He's testifying only from notes. So, Chris, hopefully some of this wound up helping you.
One more thing. The most important thing is not the legalese that you say. There aren't special words. You know, the arguments that you make are going to be the most important thing. But the one special word that you have to say a lot is objection. Make sure you say that a lot.
Okay.
Object to everything.
So, Chris, hopefully things work out for you. And definitely give us a call and let us know how things went for you. So let's get back to the article here about unfriending Facebook people. And apparently one guy says that that's bigotry. Let me back up a little bit here in the story. He was talking about right after the Caitlyn Jenner news broke, apparently it was all a buzz on his Facebook feed. And he says, happily scrolling my feed as I sip my coffee, I see yet another status threatening the dreaded unfriend. I stop and read to see what the button, or rather to see what button is being pushed for this particular Facebook user. And no surprise, it was Caitlyn Jenner. I'll paraphrase here, but the gist is that if you post anything negative about someone who is transgender or disagree with Caitlyn being called a hero, you will be deleted. They threw out the word bigotry, and I could barely stand the irony. So we'll continue with that when we come back. And of course, time for your calls if you call now, 855-450-FREE.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting. And they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays. Exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live, kicking off the final segment of the show. Might be able to squeeze in your calls if you call right now. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We'll get back to the story here about unfriending someone on Facebook. Is it bigotry or hypocrisy? Well, the author is sort of leaning that way. I'll tell you more in just a moment. But if you spend Bitcoins, one of the oldest and largest Bitcoin merchant directories is for sale. With over 10,000 Bitcoin accepting merchants listed, they've had over 3 million page views since their inception. And the number one Google search term is, where can I spend Bitcoin? Sell Bitcoin, sell ads, sell premium listings. The world is your oyster with Spend Bitcoins. That's spendbitcoins.com/sell. There are over 100,000 merchants that accept Bitcoin. Spendbitcoin.com lists over 10,000 of these merchants. Spendbitcoins.com/sell. So the story here comes from Mad World News, and the author is telling his story of what happened on his Facebook feed after the news about Caitlyn Jenner came about, and, well, he saw some people defriending others on Facebook, throwing around the B word, bigotry, and he says that he could barely stand the irony. He writes, "You see, bigotry is intolerance towards those who hold a different opinion. So the very person threatening to delete others, if they say anything they don't agree with about Caitlyn Jenner, is the real bigot. I don't know when the left decided to try to change the meaning of bigotry to intolerance towards liberal ideology and belief, but I'd love for them to know that it doesn't mean what they think it means. More often than not, when the word slips out of their mouths or off their fingertips as they type a status about intolerant conservatives or intolerant Christians, they are displaying bigotry in its finest form. I have one more definition for them. Hypocrisy. The practice of claiming to have moral standards or beliefs to which one's own behavior does not conform. If you are entitled to have and share your opinion, why are those who have a different mindset not entitled to do the same? To throw a virtual temper tantrum where you state that you will not tolerate a difference of opinion within your feed is not only bigotry, it is also hypocrisy when you are claiming that those on the other side are the intolerant bigots." So what do you guys think of this? Is it bigotry or hypocrisy to unfriend someone on Facebook?
No.
Johnson?
I don't know. I don't do it. So, you know, for then generally, the only time I've ever unfriended people for the most part is if they feel like using violence on other people is acceptable. So does that make me a bigot if I don't like to be friends with people who are dangerous? I don't know.
I block people all the time, but that's just if they annoy me.
Oh, I never block anyone.
Oh, my block list is long.
Actually, no, I'm sorry. I take that back. There's a specific group of people who I've blocked every single member of. So I went through and just like, oh, this group is a hate group. I'm just going to have fun blocking every single one of them so that I'm completely invisible to them.
Hmm.
And that was fun.
Yeah, I don't know. Facebook and social media to a degree does allow you to like shield your eyes from a particular world, you
right.
know, like you can make your own little bubble if you want to and block people off, you know, but
that'd be too much work. I've got multiple profiles.
So, yeah. Well, one of the things that I'll remove someone from my friend list for is if they advocate war, like, you know, we got to go kill all the Muslims. Or, you know, like violence against immigrants or anti-immigrant sentiment. Like, you know, we need to build a big wall and keep them out. Well, no, we don't need to keep them out because any wall that can, you know, quote unquote, keep them out can also keep you in. That was the real purpose of the Berlin Wall. It wasn't to keep people from, flooding into East Germany or East Berlin. It was to keep people from escaping East Germany and East Berlin. So, I'm not at all, losing any sleep over deleting somebody off of my friends list because they're posting horrible, bigoted views and things about, all immigrants are horrible or all Muslims need to die. Those are bigoted views. And, my profile, I get to set the boundaries of what I see. I don't want to see it.
I get nervous, though. I think Google Plus does this very well among social media where you have
people
circles.
People use Google Plus?
Yeah. So you have circles and only certain circles can see certain things. Facebook is similar, but I'm worried that my family will see some the things that I post, like strong political opinions, and I'm like, I don't want to bring that up. I don't want my family to
I have to drop something that bothers me about all social networks, but specifically Google Plus. Right. And I know a lot of people don't use Google Plus. During the first few weeks of Google Plus, I suggested this, and I still feel like, and Google Plus is kind of dying.
Yeah.
And this could save Google Plus. So if anybody is from Google is listening, open your ears. Because the thing that I've always wanted to see with Google Plus that would make me switch from Facebook in a heartbeat, the circles feature I think is great. Here's what I'd like to see. I'd like to be able to open up some circles, make those circles available, and have them be opt-in. In other words, friend,
yeah,
and
public.
I could say, this is my, not necessarily public, friends only or whatever.
Yeah, but so that I could see Johnson has a friend circle. I want to join that.
Sure, or Johnson has a circle about his political views, or Johnson has a circle about comedy, or Johnson has a circle about art.
Oh, and I can subscribe to all of those.
Right, and you could subscribe, or some of those.
Or
you could be like, I don't
comedy, not
care
art.
About his political views.
Yeah.
I want to hear only the funny stuff and maybe see the art stuff.
That could happen with cryptography. Have you heard about the idea of having a cryptographic social network? And the idea would be you publish everything publicly,
right.
But only certain people have private keys. So,
right.
Only certain people can decode what you're publishing to everyone.
Way too complicated for the average person, but yeah.
It doesn't need to be complicated.
Right.
It could be a little app right within your browser. The average user wouldn't even have to see it.
Right. Yeah, see the back end of it.
So
but it's essentially, if you were having that opt-in circles thing with Google, that's essentially what it would be. I mean, if it's password protected or whatever, then it is kind of encrypted to the non.
So basically what you're suggesting, Derrick, and correct me if I'm, mishearing this, is that all computers should be Chromebooks where nothing is stored on a hard drive locally. Everything is stored on the internet servers.
I have no
servers.
Idea what you're talking about.
You said everything should be posted publicly, but only certain people get to see it. And with Chromebooks, there is no internal memory on the device.
Okay.
So the laptop that is a Chromebook has no internal memory. Everything is stored on Google Docs or a Google Drive.
All right.
So what you're suggesting is that everything is stored on some server somewhere. And people that you give access to get to see everything.
Doesn't necessarily imply that it's stored somewhere. My idea has nothing to do with where the information is stored. It could be one of those shared internet projects.
Federation,
but if everything is public, then I either need to have direct access to your laptop.
No.
Or stuff from your laptop is stored somewhere else.
Yes and no. What's called federation is where content is networked, so each individual laptop would become a node in a federated network.
Yeah.
It's not common in practice now, but you could have a federated network.
But it could be. That's
right.
They're talking about building a second internet on top of the internet that currently exists, because the one that we have now wasn't really designed for what we're doing with it. And so allowing nodes to share different websites would allow the websites that are visited more commonly, most frequently, to load faster. And that would be great for everyone.
But I think just on a
there would be more copies of them on the nodes.
Simple, way more dumbed down, kind of simple level, just having people have the ability to opt in to certain facets of people's personalities. Like, there are so many people where I follow, it's like, I don't want to hear about everything that you have to say. Some of the stuff you say is stupid.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear about it. But I do really like what you have to say about this. And I feel like if people were to be able to have this sort of level of opt-in content, it would also make people better.
Well,
because you, yes, because you'd see.
They wouldn't be as well-rounded, would like, they? Because they would encounter the things that they don't want
to
encounter.
Maybe they shouldn't be. Maybe people, some,
sure.
No,
okay.
I mean.
I buy that.
But like, you know, what I'm saying is on the receiving end, like you'd be sitting there and going like, oh, people don't really care to see my political views. It, like, they really want to hear about, you know, whatever other topic. You know, like for me, maybe people wouldn't want to look at my politics. Maybe they'd be much more interested in my art, or maybe they'd be interested in my jokes. Like, I don't know. And it would be really interesting to find out what interests people, and then you could focus on that more. And that would make you a better person because you'd be more entertaining or whatever to people, or more interesting.
I love where you're going with this idea, and hopefully somebody somewhere takes
smarter
off and
me.
Runs with it. And you can take all of the archives, freetalklive.com. We'll be back tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal.